Welcome to Advent. At St. John's, can you believe it's already 2023? We're entering into a season of preparation and waiting, the coming of the Christ child, anew and afresh in our life. This is a season of 4 weeks, and we'll have several themes: love, hope, peace, and joy. And during this time, we will sing hymns like, O come, Emmanuel, come thy long expected Jesus. And we will be reminded of scriptures that include people like Zechariah and Elizabeth and the coming of their unborn child, John. We know that Elizabeth and Mary, Jesus's mom, were cousins. But what you might not know is that Zechariah had been a priest for a long time, and he and his wife now were very old, but they had never been blessed with any children. And Zechariah was doing his duties in the temple, burning incense, when all of a sudden he was visited by an angel. And Zechariah was startled. And the angel Gabriel told him that they would have a child. And it was like unbelievable. And he said to the angel, "Don't you know that we are old now? We're way beyond childbearing years." And the angel said, "You and your wife, Elizabeth, will have a child." Sometimes we hear stories like this and we think, can it be true? Recently, a friend shared this story with me. Listen, as the holiday season in 1938 came to Chicago, Bob May wasn't feeling much joy. A 30-year-old writer from Montgomery Ward, May was exhausted and nearly broke for caring for his wife, Evelyn, who was bedridden after 2 long years of battling cancer. This left Bob to take care of his 4-year-old daughter, Barbara. One night, Barbara and Bob were having only a discussion like a father and daughter could have, and she said to her dad, "Why isn't mommy like everybody else's mommy?" And he struggled to answer his daughter's question. And Bob remembered the pain in his own childhood, a small, sickly child, constantly being picked on and called names. But he wanted to give his own daughter hope. And so he showed her that being different was nothing to be ashamed of. More than that, he wanted her to know that he loved her more than life itself, and that he was going to do anything in his power to take care of her. And so he began to spin a tale about a reindeer with a bright nose who found a special place in Santa's team. Barbara loved this story so much that she would have her father to tell her this story over every single night. And as he did, the story became more elaborate because he couldn't afford that year to buy any toys or gifts for his daughter. He decided that he was going to take his gift as a writer and turn it into a homemade picture book. Early in December, Bob's wife died. Though he was heartbroken, he kept working on the book for his daughter. And a few days before Christmas, he reluctantly attended a Christmas party at Montgomery Ward. and his co-workers encouraged him to share the story that he had been working on so diligently for his daughter. And after he read it there, he got a standing ovation, and everybody wanted their own copy. And Montgomery Ward bought the rights to the book, and it helped this debt-ridden employee. And over the next 6 years, at Christmas, they gave away more than 6 million copies of Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer to shoppers. Every major publishing house in the country was making all kind of offers to obtain this book. In an incredible display of goodwill, the head of the department store returned all the rights to Bob May. 4 years later, Rudolph made him a millionaire. Now remarried with a growing family, May felt blessed by his good fortunes. But there was more to come. His brother-in-law was a successful songwriter named Johnny Marks. And setting that music to some uplifting music, the song he pitched to artists like Bing Crosby, but all of them turned him down. And then finally, Marks approached Gene Autry, the cowboy star who had scored a holiday hit with Here Comes Santa Claus just a few years earlier. And like others, Autry was not impressed with the song about misfit reindeers. But Marks begged him to give it a second listen, and Autry played it for his wife, Anna. And she was so touched by the line that they wouldn't let the poor Rudolph play any of the reindeer games, that she insisted on her husband to record that tune. Within just a few years, it became one of the best-selling Christmas songs ever, right behind White Christmas. See, both of these stories that I have shared with you, the Elizabeth and Zachariah story, the Bob May story, who was a struggling writer with Montgomery Ward, caring for his wife and making sure that his daughter, Barbara, was going to be taken care of. Neither one of them saw any hope. They didn't see anything in the future. But what they didn't understand was God was already planning to do something marvelous in all of our lives. For Zechariah and Elizabeth, they sent John, that we know as John the Baptist, to be the forerunner of Jesus. And we all know the story and the birth of Jesus. And we know today what having Jesus in our life and how that makes a difference day by day. I pray that as we begin this season of Advent together, that we will all live in to the hope, to the love, to the joy, and the peace that will come to all of us as we look into the future for the expectant coming of the Christ child anew and afresh in our life. Friends, let us pray. Lord, our whole life is a story. A story in the beginning that God created all of us. A story on the night in a stable so long ago, the Christ child was born for us. Lord, as we journey through these 4 weeks of Advent, help us in our season of preparation and waiting for the greatest gift that we shall receive, the gift of the Christ child. In the name of Christ we pray. Amen.